Aloha, this is Heidi at Easy Peasy. In this video, I'm going to share a 3 months old update of how it's been going practicing elimination communication and clock diapering with natural diapers and wool diaper covers. The last update I shared was our newborn update when my son was 1 month old. I'm sorry I didn't get around to doing a 2 months update. At that time, I was working really hard on editing and uploading the videos showing how all of his newborn cloth diapers fit him. If you haven't already seen that, you can go ahead and watch that playlist after this video. Right now, when I'm recording this video, he's currently 12 weeks old. So I guess by the calendar, he's not quite 3 months, but he'll be there pretty soon. So I'll talk about how it's been going these past couple months. For elimination communication, in my 1 month update, I was just timidly getting started with it. Already by 2 months, it was a normal part of our daily routine, and now at 3 months, we're really into the swing of practicing EC. I've been offering the potty mostly at transition times, so during diaper changes, anytime he wakes up, before and after nursing, especially after nursing, is usually when we might catch a poop. Before putting him into the carrier, and then as soon as we get home and I take him out of the carrier, or if he signals. With a boy, it's been working really well to put a little cloth wipe over his lap so that pee doesn't spray out of the potty. I just use this insert from the baby Bjorn potty, put it in my lap. I keep everything right next to the bed so I can just reach over and grab it. The potty insert, and then just set it back in. I can grab some wipes, wet them with this water. Clean diapers right next to me in the cart. And then in here I have some Mother Love diaper balm. I have a spray that I made out of equal parts witch hazel, alcohol-free, and aloe vera gel. So sometimes I use that for cleaning his bottom. Some diaper pins. I have them locked up in here so my toddler doesn't grab them. And then other types of fasteners I have in here. Boingo ones I use sometimes with preflats. It's getting a little bit harder now to tell if he's signaling. Sometimes it might just be fussiness, looking a bit agitated. I used to be able to know if he started trying to climb out of my arms, but now he's just trying to get everything. He wants to go for things. He wants to grab things, even though he can't quite yet. So he's often trying to crawl out of my arms, and I don't think that's any longer a potty signal that we can rely upon. For nighttime, we have started practicing nighttime EC. It kind of varies from night to night. If he wakes up to nurse with a dry diaper, then I'll offer the potty. However, if he wakes up and his diaper's already wet and he's still mostly still asleep, then I don't want to disturb him too much. So in that case, I'll just change his diaper, nurse him, we both go back to sleep. Lately, with his first wake up at night, normally his diaper is dry, but even if I do offer the potty, he won't go. He's like so sound asleep at that point. So often I just don't even bother offering the potty at the very first wake up. But then chances are he'll have a wet diaper by his next wake up. At this point, he's only waking to nurse about 3 times at night, which is nice because if you watched my previous video, when he was really newbie those first 2-3 weeks, I was going through about 10 cloth diapers at night, changing him every time he was wet. Now, I don't look at the clock when he wakes up, so I don't know exactly what his stretches are. But in the morning, it's like, oh, I changed like 3 diapers at night and then changing again in the morning. A big change now that he's 3 months old is that we're normally catching his poops in the potty in the morning time. So generally when he wakes around 5 or 6 a.m., he'll do a poop in the potty, go back to sleep, and then when we wake for the day around 7 or 8 a.m., we normally catch another poop in the potty. So that's not to say there won't be any other poops the rest of the day. He might have a small poop here or there, but it's not just like all throughout the day constantly pooping. Also, I remember telling people that normally with my first 2 babies, around 2 months old is when they stopped pooping out and about away from home. And I had just been thinking about that when we went to visit my sister-in-law, that he had just been like pooping constantly, even if we were out visiting her. And I was like, man, I thought that 2 months is a change. And the next time we went out, he was just like at the 2 months old age, and he barely pooped while we were away from home, just a little bit, and mostly waited to poop in the potty. So once again, that is a big benefit and advantage that I enjoy about EC, is they kind of learn that home is the place to go poop. You may be able to relate to that, but it makes it nicer cloth diapering away from home when there's not so many poopy diapers. For any of you who are really new to EC, or you're just considering doing it with your newborn, I don't want you to get too confused or hung up on the idea of full-time EC versus part-time EC. I see these terms thrown around in the support groups, and there's no set definition of what either of those mean. So I say I practice full-time EC, meaning it's always something I'm thinking about, I'm aware about, I communicate with my baby about it. But full-time EC does not mean that we catch everything in the potty. We certainly don't. A lot still goes into the diapers. And it also doesn't mean that we're diaper free all the time. We're most of the time using diaper backups. It is really nice now that we are starting to use fewer backups. If you watched my previous video, I was washing 30 diapers a day, and that was diapers he wore and also ones we were using to line his change pad, or maybe we'd use a flat as a burp rag. So it wasn't ones he was peeing or pooping in all of them, but I was washing about 30 diapers a day. Then it reduced down to about 20 diapers a day. So let's talk about the cloth diaper stash. I did record a little clip right when he had turned 2 months old showing what our diaper stash was at that time. So I'm going to show you that, and then I'll talk a little bit about where our diaper stash is going from here. I just want to show you real quickly what the diaper stash is moving towards. So we are still using these newborn muslin flats, even though they're getting a bit small. And we've added in a couple preflats, moved up to the size 2 of the Lulu-Doo fitted diapers, have just a couple all-in-ones. This basket has the snap-in inserts for our Poppy snap-in-one diapers, and we're still using the novice prefolds, even though those are getting a bit small as well. We've moved up to using the one size Poppy wool covers and a size medium baby greens wool cover. He does still fit in the mini one size Poppy wool cover as well, but that's also getting a little bit small. So this is what we have right now, but we're still kind of transitioning away from the newborn flats and the novice prefolds, and we need something to fill that gap. Currently for the wool diaper covers, we have one baby greens size medium wool diaper cover, which he is wearing right now while he's asleep in bed for the night. I like the baby greens one because it's roomy enough to fit either one of these Lulu-Doo size 2 fitted diapers under, or we're also using the novice prefolds under that as well. And I don't have to worry about putting something a bit bulkier on under that. So I think we're gonna keep using that as our nighttime option. It's great during the day as well. To me, the baby greens isn't quite as cute as my other covers, but it's very reliable. I also have 3 of the Poppy one size wool diaper covers, and these ones are just so cute. They're so beautiful. I have this minty green one in the one size, and I sewed some inserts to go in it. I also have some of the Poppy inserts that you can buy directly from their website. I'll link some stores below if you're interested in getting these diapers. There are some online retailers in the US, or the covers themselves are made in Poland and you can order from there as well if you're interested. I have been really liking these. They look cute, they're super trim, but since they're so trim fitting, not all of our absorbency fits under them. Like, it wouldn't quite cover this fitted diaper. So it's nice to have some other options that can fit over more things. All of my Poppy ones are the snap-in-one option where they have these internal snaps. Some of them are just covers, so if you're interested in ordering, make sure you check and see if you're ordering the SIO snap-in-one, or if you're just ordering a straight-up cover, then it wouldn't have these internal snaps. And we now have one with hook and loop closure. I had been sticking mostly with snaps this time around. For EC, it can be really nice to have the convenience of easily taking off the cover. So far I'm enjoying this. I find the fit is not quite as good as with the snap versions, but I think for the convenience, it's worth it for now. Once he gets old enough to take the Velcro off, it might not work so well to keep the cover on him. So one baby greens, three poppy, although I do sometimes get tempted to buy even more of them whenever they release a new cover. I was good this last time around, I didn't buy any. And then we have one pair of extra small Truly Caris mid-weight wool bubble shorts, and I really like these either whenever we're going out, I dress him in these because it looks more like clothes, and I also like these as well at nighttime because they'll fit over the bulky fitted diapers. And sometimes if I've had to, I'll snappy on the pre-fold underneath these too, but at this point I can hardly snappy on those novice pre-folds, and I don't have any plans of getting any bigger size pre-folds after this. To me, they just get to be too bulky of an option. I've been washing and lanolizing wool covers about once a week, usually just a couple covers at a time. Sometimes the covers get poopy, I wash them, lanolize them, and the next day he spits up on it. So sometimes I go a whole week between washing and then end up washing them 2 days in a row. Those five wool covers are what we're using right now, but I am planning ahead. I've gone ahead and ordered a pair of toddler small Truly Caris shorties. And so when I buy an interlock wool cover for my kids, I think about getting a long time usage out of it because they are quite expensive. They're made right here in the United States. It's a family business where the husband dyes the wool, the wife sews, and she also contracts out to some other people to sew them as well. But the price reflects that you're supporting a made in the USA business. And so I want to make sure I'm going to get a lot of use out of them if I'm going to be paying that price for them. So I ordered him the toddler small shorties, and with Truly Caris, where the sizing works, it's not like you would go through baby small, medium, large, and then hit the toddler sizes. Instead, the baby small kind of parallels the toddler small, but they're just a different cut. The toddler versions are kind of lower cut, and they're designed to be easier to pull down and pull up, and that's what I am always looking for in diaper covers, and that's also why I like roomy bubble shorts, because they're so roomy around the hips, easier up and down than something like a soaker that can get too tight around the hips and kind of tight on the butt and be harder to pull down. So with those toddler shorties, my plan is hopefully he'll start fitting into them around the waist pretty soon. I don't know, I haven't gotten them yet, but they'll be like pants on him because he's just a little baby, right? And then they'll kind of be like capris on him. And then there'll be shorts on him. And then hopefully he'll still be wearing them as a toddler. We'll see how that goes. So then the plan for the absorbency to go under the covers. I will be using those snap-in inserts like I showed you. They're not great for containing the liquid, exclusively breastfed, newborn poop, whatever you want to call it. I tend to wait until he's pooped in the potty and then put him in one of those snap-in ones. Otherwise, I like something more wrapped around him for better containment. I'm planning to phase out the novice pre-folds, phase out the newborn muslin flats, which we haven't been using too much anymore, only if I really need to. I have tried like pad folding them in the baby greens cover, and that works okay. Probably not quite as much absorbency as we need now. So the way I am headed with our diaper stash is preflats and stretchy flats. I have a couple examples here of preflats. So this is a one size from Noble Bebe. And this is one from Fruit of the Womb, that's a size 3. So when I first kind of got reintroduced to preflats, I had heard about them before. I had actually intended to sew some before my baby was born, but I ran out of time to. And then when they kind of became popular again, everybody was talking about preflats. What I was thinking is like, oh, so maybe I could pin these two wings together, and then when I need to offer the potty, I could drop down the diaper off the potty, tuck it back in. So I started learning how to use diaper pins, but I'm still kind of afraid of them. I put one on him like that one time, and then I was like, oh, I don't know about this pin. I took it off, I put a Boingo, and when I went to change him, I unsnapped the Boingo and it like attacked my finger, put holes in my finger. So I don't know, pins, Boingo, snappy, I guess they could all get you. But I thought the idea that this could be a good EC backup. I'm not sure, especially with a boy though, if it's gonna really work very well to re-tuck it up there. I'm still kind of playing around with it. One thing I do really like about preflats is that they're so trim. They're such a trim option that they will fit well under these poppy covers. And I even have this super unique diaper I'm playing around with. This is a contour diaper, and it's made completely of wool. So you could use lanolized wool as a water repellent diaper cover to keep the moisture in the diaper, or you could use wool as the absorbing portion itself. So I've just started to experiment with that. So far, this is way more absorbent of a diaper than we need. I've been putting like a little cotton insert in it, and then when he pees, the cotton gets wet and the wool gets just like a teeny tiny wet, and I have to go through the trouble of hand washing it. So if you have a super heavy wetter and you're looking for like a nighttime diaper to keep on them for most of the night, then it might be a good idea for you to look into this wool. I'll link below. These are made by the Atlas Butt, and they were called Stretchy Flats as like their brand name before, but since that's a generic term, they just changed it to the Atlas Butt. My plan is to place the order with Fruit of the Womb for both preflats and stretchy flats. I'll leave my referral link below. As always, I really appreciate when you do purchase through those or use my referral coupon codes as well, because I normally earn either a small store credit or some small monetary amount too when you use my links. I want to talk about some reasons why I'm going towards the flats and preflats. Number one is we generally are a traveling family. We've been stationary in Hawaii this past year, but previously we were traveling full time. But we are hoping that when our son is around 6 months old, we'll be moving back to Asia. And when we do, I don't know exactly what our washing situation will be. We may have a washing machine, but it may be cold water only. Most likely wherever we go, we'll be hanging dry our laundry. So I really want to have some travel-friendly diapers in our stash. I also like the snap-in inserts because of that. Each portion is only 2 layers thick. So it's got a couple layers, and a couple layers to help it with the washing and drying. And then also with the preflats, they're just like 2 layers thick. And with the flat stretchy cloth diapers, sorry, they're in the wash right now, so I don't have one to show you, but they're just one single layer, so even easier to wash and dry. So travel friendly. Also, I am planning to participate in the flats and hand washing challenge, which will be starting on May 17th. The original intent of the flats and hand washing challenge was to bring awareness to diaper need. Even before the pandemic, 1 in 3 families in the US struggled to afford diapers. And coming up very soon, in about June, it's forecasted that disposable diaper prices are going to increase. Again, because of COVID, the supply chain, things are getting more expensive for them. They'll be passing on the increased cost to people. So it's really important right now for people who are struggling to afford diapers to know that cloth can be an option. But often for lower income people, they might also have difficulty accessing washing facilities. They may not have a washer and dryer at home. Going to a laundromat can be cost prohibitive. I know personally with my second baby, I chose to wash diapers even though all we had was coin operated washer and dryer in our apartment. And I was paying about $50 a month to wash her diapers. So that's a privilege, that's a luxury that because I wanted to, I could afford the diapers, I could afford the washing. Somebody who's really low income, struggling to buy disposables, they're probably not going to be able to afford to wash those diapers in a laundromat. So if people know that they're both are inexpensive options for diapers, like flat diapers, which you can make do it yourself, you can upcycle them, you can get some of the cheaper options like flour sack towels, or get flats from Green Mountain Diapers. If they know that those type of things exist and that you can hand wash them at home, that can open up a way that people can save money, be good for the environment, be good for their baby, not have to pay the outrageous prices for disposable diapers. So I'm really excited that the timing is working out this year, that I will be able to participate in the flats and hand washing challenge. I know some people will be focusing more on the low cost aspect. I am going to come up with my own twist. The rules this year said you don't have to stick strictly to flats and hand washing. You can kind of make your own challenge, whatever that may be. And so for me, my challenge is going to incorporate using preflats, flats, hand washing in a manner that is travel friendly. So I'm basically going to be practicing for when we travel or move, what way I could wash the diapers by hand if I needed to. And I'm thinking that I will use just 2 wool covers for the challenge. I often respond when people ask, like, what's the minimum number of wool covers? I say 4. But truthfully, if I were to do the challenge with 4, that would be super easy. Even 3, that would be really easy for me. It's a 1-week challenge. I think to make it a challenge, I'm going to try and see how it would be getting by with just 2 wool covers. It's open to anybody to participate in the flats and hand washing challenge. So even if you don't make videos for YouTube, even if you don't post photos on Instagram, even if you're not a blogger, you still can participate. It's just a great way to kind of open your mind to the possibilities, see what it's like to do something different. I've heard from a lot of people that their diapers come cleaner washing them by hand than they did in their washing machine. So if you're also struggling a bit with your wash routine, you might want to join on in and try hand washing and see if that works out better for you. This year it's going to be hosted again by the Cloth Diaper Podcast, and I'll leave a link in the description box below where you can get all the details for the upcoming flats and hand washing challenge. Perhaps the biggest update is that my baby hit a big milestone in becoming mobile. So I thought I had a good another 2-3 months before he hit mobility. I could experiment with stretchy flats and wool, see what works good under wool covers, and then he started rolling away from his diaper changes. And it got a lot harder to secure pre-folds onto him or put flats on him, and I started to think, man, I wasn't expecting this so soon. Should we be going right to training pants again? With my daughter, once she outgrew her newborn diapers, we did start introducing training pants, although we also had diapers as well. This time around, I just wanted to get more time in experimenting with cloth diapers before we moved on. Starting from 10 weeks old, he started rolling, where he goes from back to belly, and then he kind of pushes with his feet so he can scoop forward. So I don't know, it's not like crawling on hands and knees, but he's moving forward in a prone position, which is, I guess, the definition of crawling. So I wasn't expecting that at 2.5 months old. We do make an effort to parent in a way that allows for natural movement, so I try not to restrain his movement. We've been just changing his diaper on a flat wool pad on the bed, so when I lay him down, I take off his diaper, wipe him, he kind of rolls away. I bring him back, offer the potty, set him down, he rolls away, get his diaper ready, the fresh one, bring him back, put the diaper on. So it's quite a process now. It's getting a bit more tricky to get those diapers on. Over the weekend was another cloth diaper related event. It was the Great Cloth Diaper Change, the 11th annual one. And the idea behind that was just to get as many people around the world as possible all changing their baby into a cloth, reusable, washable diaper at the same time. In the past, they tried to do it really synchronized. This year and last year, it was more online events and it was over 3 different days. And so we just had to change her baby in a cloth diaper at some point over the weekend. If you didn't know about for this year, but you want to participate for next year, you really only need to have 1 cloth diaper, because you could start them in a disposable, change them into the cloth diaper, or they could be in a cloth diaper and change into another cloth diaper. Just another way to spread awareness of cloth diapering. Please subscribe for more on elimination communication and natural cloth diapering.